Okay. So let's look at number three.
For that second box, would it be okay if we wrote stuff in there like that, just to?
I want to leave that blank for now, so that's what I wanted to do. Number three, we're going to plug two in there for x. I like to think of x as an empty set of parentheses, as a blank set of parentheses, and that is exactly what x's job is to be a blank spot for x to go, for whatever number is supposed to be equal to x for it to go there. Okay. So if x is a blank set of parentheses and we plug 2 there, then it should look like 2 minus 3 plus 6 minus 2 times 2, not 3, 2. All right. So what should we do first? Kelly.
Do the 2 minus 3.
Okay, 2 minus 3 now.
No, you don't have
1. What about this multiplication, though, Kelly? Doesn't multiplication always come before addition and subtraction?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Why?
Because of PEMDAS.
Okay. Because of PEMDAS. Now, it's too much talking.
PEMDAS.
I'm talking to Kelly. That's the only noise that there should be right now. Will it make a difference if I subtract the 3 from the 2? Before I multiply this negative 2 by negative, or this negative 2 times 2?
No.
Mm-mm. No.
Will it affect the final answer?
No.
No. But yes.
You
no,
sure?
Would it?
No.
Wait, I'm
no.
Would it?
No.
No.
No, it would not affect the final answer.
Okay. If it's not going to affect the final answer, then it doesn't matter if we do it first, does it?
Mm-hmm.
The multiplication before addition and subtraction thing, this is what it's really trying to help us with, make us do, or whatever. We multiply this by this before we subtract any of this from 6. That's the multiplication before addition. We're multiplying, when we talk about this number negative 2, we can subtract it from 6, or we can multiply it by 2. Which do we do first? Right. That's the multiplication before addition or subtraction, the multiplication of this particular number. Since this particular number is involved in a subtraction from 6 and a multiplication by 2. Right? We multiply by 2 before we add or subtract, because to make one decision or the other does change the final answer. If I subtract 3 from 2 before I multiply this 2 by 2, it does not affect the final answer. You get the exact same thing either way. Okay? That's one of those things where I like you to think of for yourself, right? If it doesn't change the final answer, then it well, must be just fine. Okay, Kelly?
I kind of did those at the same time. I did 2 minus 3.
You got negative 1.
Negative 1 plus 6 minus 4.
Uh-huh.
So
you did
the
same
step.
Same
time.
Okay, so not even one before the other, at the same time?
Mm-hmm.
Sure, it's not going to affect the final answer, and that comes a little bit with practice, right? I'm going to look at it, I'm going to try it out, I'm going to do them at the same time, I'll do one before the other, it turns out I'm going to get the same answer, okay? So I can kind of see into the future. Well, if I multiply these together first before I do this, I'm going to wind up doing a 2 minus 3 anyway at some point. It's not going to affect the final answer. So negative 2 times positive 2 is negative 4, negative 1 plus 6 minus 4. Right? What's that?
You can add the negatives.
Add the negatives? Can I do negative 1 minus 4?
Yeah.
Let's take a vote. Can we do negative 1 minus 4? Yes?
Is that plus or positive 6?
No.
Well, it's plus 6.
Oh, okay. Never mind. Additionally.
So he says we can add, I can take the negative 1 and just subtract 4 from that. Can we do that? Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Thumbs up for yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thumbs down for no, you can't do that.
Cool.
Let's try it and see if there's any difference. Okay. We'll do it kind of the straightforward way. Negative 1 plus 6 is what?
Negative 7.
5. No, it's 5.
Negative 1
5.
Plus 6 is 5. Minus 4
is
1. Okay, let's do it the other way. Let's do that negative 1 minus 4 first. We get negative 5.
Plus 6.
Plus 6 is?
1.
1.
Oh.
And it's not a coincidence. Sometimes you get the right answer, or you get the answer that's the same as the right answer, and it's a coincidence. It's not a coincidence. Think about being on a number line, which is a good way to visualize addition and subtraction. So we're at, there's zero. Let's see. If I do negative one, so that's back here, and then I go forward six, one, two, three, four, five, six, and then I go back four, one, two, three, four, well, there I am at one. It's going to really make a difference if I go back one, and back four more, two, three, four, and then forward six. I think I went back five. Back one, then back four, and then forward six. I still end up at one. Back one, back one, two, three, four, and forward six. One, two, three, four, five, six. There we are again at one.
Yep.
Right? The moral of the story is? What's the moral of the story there? What am I showing you by going on this number line back and forth in all sorts of different orders?
If you subtract the negative, it doesn't matter because you're
doesn't matter because we're adding a bunch of numbers together. It doesn't matter which order we add those numbers together. Because what we really have there, I'm gonna write here, but don't, if you can avoid it, don't write here. I'm taking negative one, I'm adding six, and I'm adding negative four. Whether I add negative one and six first, and then negative four, or add negative one and negative four first, or six and negative four first, it's not gonna make any difference because it's just jumping around in the number line, and in the end, I wind up in the same place.
Yep.
And that's true of addition. If I'm adding a bunch of numbers, I can do them in any order. So I'm using a couple of things called the commutative property and the associative property of addition. And they're almost like common sense properties of addition. It just doesn't matter which order I do them in. Okay? The commutative property would be if I take this negative four and actually move it over here next to the negative one and add those together. The associative would be, well, if I add these together first and then this, or these together first and then this, it doesn't make a difference. Brenda?
I got three. I'm not sure.
Not sure how you got three?
Two minus three is negative one.
That's so funny.
So two minus three is negative one, that's six. That's negative one.
You're so like my dog. She looks like my dog with asthma attacks.
I should probably take them around.
You don't smell that.
Next, is there one that we should also go over? Seven? Okay, seven. I heard seven, I'm doing seven. Here we go with seven. Nine plus five times negative eight minus nine times negative eight. Should I do nine plus five is 14?
No.
Why not?
There's
okay, so.
No, there's not.
Yes, there is.
What?
No, multiply.
It's multiply, not parentheses.
Wait, what?
It's true.
They're the same practical.
No.
The same thing.
The reason why we do not add 5 and 9 and get 14 is because we should multiply the 5 by this thing first. The parentheses part, there's no parentheses to do here. Parentheses means look inside parentheses and do operations inside the parentheses. Is there anything to do here?
No.
Yeah.
It's just a number.
No.
There's well, nothing to do.
Yeah, but
that's the multiply. I'm talking about the parentheses part.
Oh.
Is there anything to do in the parentheses?
No.
No. Whereas something like 5 times 4 plus 7, right?
That's something.
Let's add these together first, then multiply by 5. We're not going to multiply 5 by 4 and then add 7. We're going to do inside the parentheses. First, that's what parentheses is talking about. Inside the parentheses, do all that stuff. The reason why we do 5, we don't add 5 to 9, we do the 5 times the 8 is because multiplication, not because of parentheses. I could write that in a different way. I don't have to write parentheses. I could write 5 dot negative 8 right? It's just multiplying together. Mm-hmm. So we multiply these first, right? And 5 times negative 8 is what?
Negative 40.
Okay, then we have multiplication here, so we should do that too, right? So what do we get?
Negative 72.
Okay, who's seeing 9 times negative 8? Who's seeing negative 9 times negative 8? And who's seeing 9 times negative 8? We can view it either way. We just need to make sure that we keep the signs straight, okay? You might be seeing, you're just kind of blind to this negative and you're just seeing the 9 times negative 8. What is a positive 9 times a negative 8?
Negative 72.
Now what am I doing with that negative 72? Subtracting. Or I notice that the negative is there, and I see it less of a minus 9, I see it more of as a negative 9, which is the same thing. Okay. So really, I'm seeing it more like plus a negative 9 times negative 8. Now, what's a negative 9 times a negative 8? What's 72? Positive 72. Right? The other way we got minus negative 72. What's minus negative 72? How do I subtract a negative?
Just write on 72
and
72.
No, what are you talking?
I'm not making fun and I'm not trying to be negative here. I'm trying to say that's like a helpful little memory trick. But if you were to ask Isaac Newton,
who's Isaac Newton?
Famous mathematician. He invented calculus. Let's say Albert Einstein. He wasn't that good at math, but we could think of him as a mathematician. So you ask Albert Einstein, right? Decent enough at math that he knows that minus a negative is the same as adding. If you ask Albert Einstein, hey, why is it that when I subtract a negative, that it's a positive? He's not going to tell you. Because that. That's not a because. This helps you remember. It's not a why. It's just a helpful reminder that that's the way it is. Okay? And it's true. Minus a negative is the same as adding. Just add a positive. Okay? But why is a negative, right? Why is subtracting a negative the same as adding a positive number? Kelly?
Like Miss Kramer tells us, like you take the subtraction, turn it, and then you put it on the negative.
And that explains why a negative minus a negative is, or a why subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive.
I don't know.
Is that the reason why? I'm going to be asking you why a lot this year, so if you don't like it, get ready to not like a lot of stuff. I'm going to ask you over and over and over why. If you don't know why, then your ability to do math is reliant on your ability to remember a bunch of stuff, which for every human being, except for a small percentage, your memories are not that great. Okay? Remember it wrong, and you remember it wrong. Understand why, and you just understand why. Okay? Did you know you can create false memories?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Have you guys ever heard of that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Did you know in your dreams?
No. We're talking about my thing. You can create a false memory.
Yes.
When you remember something, you're not actually remembering it. You're kind of accessing a computer file in a way. You go back there and you think about the last time you remembered that. Okay. Now every time you pull up that file and look at it, it can get a little bit messed up until your brain somehow constructs this memory where, you know, three Halloweens ago, you went trick-or-treating and, you know, your friend had his bag of candy stolen, and that is not what happened.
That actually happened to me.
You can make your brain alter that memory over time to the point where you actually think that's what happened. What I'm saying is, your memory of stuff is faulty. It is not perfect. Okay? It is not as good as understanding why. Are you going to tell me about dreams now, Colby?
Yep.
We're going to have to skip past it, because we're going to continue with this.
Okay.
Not that I'm not interested, it's just we have to get to this, okay? So, subtracting a negative, all right, well, why is that adding? Let's look at a number line, okay? Let's say we're somewhere on the number line, okay? Now if I want, stop, put the hand down. So if I was going to add a number, which direction would I go on the number line?
Right.
Well, that way. Okay. Because that's the positive direction, right? I'm going to get bigger in that direction. What about subtracting? Which way would I go? Left. Okay. All right. But now we have to throw in these numbers, these negative numbers. Okay. So if I want to add, right, I'm thinking, I'm going to go this way. I'm going to add a number. What number am I going to add? I add 5, great, I add 5. Add 7, great, go that way, 7. But if I add a negative 3, right, if I add a negative 3, I'm going to wind up going to the left. Okay? If I add a negative 3, I go to the left. Okay? Now, we've added positives. We've subtracted positives. Okay? That's like first grade stuff. Subtracting. We added a negative number, we wound up going backwards, right? I'm thinking, I'm going to go this way because I'm adding, but I'm adding a number that is negative, that is left by nature. This number is a left number, it's going to the left, right? So I add it on, I tag it on, I go that way. If I'm thinking I'm going to subtract, okay, let's just think about subtracting, I'm thinking, go this way, right? Subtract, I'm going to subtract, I'm going to go left. Left is my orientation, left is the direction that I'm going to go when I subtract. But I'm going to subtract a negative number, right? So I want to go this direction, I want to subtract, but the number I'm subtracting is itself negative. So I would actually go this direction. The negative number goes in the opposite direction of the positive number, right? Positive 3 is over here, negative 3 is over there. Positive 5 is over here, negative 5 is over there. If I subtract, start to go in this direction, a negative number, right? If I'm going this way, the opposite of left is right. If I want to subtract a negative number, I actually go to the right. Okay? So to subtract a negative number, it's the same as moving to the right. Okay? It's the same as adding a number. Okay? Right? A question about that? Or a comment? Except for not about dreams. Not right now. Alright, so we subtract a negative, it's the same as adding a positive. So, whoops. The whole point of that was to say whether you view it as 9 times negative 8 and get a negative 72, make sure you're subtracting that negative 72. If you see it as a negative 9 times a negative 8, that kind of takes care of everything at once. Negative 9 times negative 8 is a positive 72, negative 10 negative 2 positive. Alright, then we have this 9. 9 minus 40 plus 72. And it should be pretty smooth sailing from here, right? 9 plus negative 40 plus 72, whatever order I want to add those together.
Isn't it minus
72? It's minus negative 72, which is the same as plus 72. Right? So if we take, we can go 9 plus 72 and get 81. And subtract 40, and we get 41. I'm sure something was funny, but is it really helping? right now. Okay. Try and take a deep breath or whatever it takes for you to stop having the giggles. So you wanted to do 8, I heard?
4.
4.
What?
Down the bottom.
Oh.
So not 4.
Not 4. All right, so we're going to plug -3 here and here for x. -10 times -3 plus 6 times -3. Then we just follow the order of operations because that's what we agreed that we would do. Cool. This is a rash of giggles out there. If you could just face forward, I think that would help. Should that? Yes?
I'll let you see it, please.
Well, don't give me the end answer. Help me walk through it.
Would it be positive 30?
-10 times -3. Who is it that needs to come sit here? Who's? Feels like Jaden every time I turn around. He's got a red face because he's trying not to laugh.
Yeah, he always.
So.
What's right now?
Okay. Let's try and put it together. -10 times -3 is +30. Okay? And +6 times -3? -18. And 30 minus 18? Okay, be careful about those positives and negatives. Keep those straight. That probably accounts for half of the mistakes that I see.
Cool. Number 8.
Number 8.
Sorry.
You do want number 8. Okay.
What?
So we're going to plug 6 in there for x. 1 minus 3 times 6 plus 10. We're looking here, we're trying to decide what to do first, right? Should I add 6 and 10?
No.
Should I subtract 3 from 1?
No. 3 times 6.
Right, because we decided that multiplication, we'll do that first before we do like subtract this from 1. So 1, -3 times 6 is -18. Okay. So we're adding a -18 there, 1 plus -18. So we're at -8 plus 10, -7.
Oh. Oh, so it would be -17 or -7.
It is
negative.
When we get all done, then we, you know, we move forward 1 and back 18 and forward 10, we wind up here at -7.
Yep.
That's where we wind up on the number line once you stop jumping around.
Okay.
Okay. All right, so here's what I want you to do. Here's the next phase. This is why I wanted you to leave the right side of these blank. So I wanted you to do this in that space. I want you to simplify each of these expressions. What do you mean? So every one of these is an expression. It's not an equation. So we're not going to solve it. You can't solve it. It's not an equation. You can't solve it. It's an expression. We're going to simplify it. It means we're just going to put things together if we can. It's kind of like you went out in a field with a bunch of animals, and they're all over the place. You would go and you would get all the cows and you put them in one place, and you put all the horses in another place, and you put all the kittens somewhere else, right? Horses and cows and kittens always roaming about together. Okay? So, here, number 8. Let's use number 8 as an example. 1 minus 3x plus 10. Well, I know that when I plug something in for x, I'm really going to wind up adding a 1 to that and adding a 10 to it, right? So it would be the same as if I added what?
Six.
If I'm going to add a 1, I'm going to add a 10
11.
To this. I might as well just, instead of adding 1 and then adding 10 later, I'll just add 11 all at once. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
We got number 8. We got a 1
minus
3x. Plus 10. Okay? Well, instead of saying I'm going to add 1 to this number and then add 10, I'll just add 11. Just combine 1 with 10, it's 11. Okay, let's look at another one. A different kind of thing that happens. Let's look at number two.
It wasn't for you this time.
7x minus x.
7x. Well, it's the same then.
Why are you laughing so much?
I know.
This is insane, Kelly.
-7x squared.
No. But I appreciate you trying to like do something.
I think he would say.
Jaden?
Never mind.
Okay.
So what?
So do you have to add it to it?
Nope. I don't want you putting any numbers in there yet. I just want you to simplify each expression. Here. Would it just be 7? That's a fine guess.
Please.
No, don't put any numbers in for x. No numbers. So no numbers. Leave x as x. So what is that? This is it, x minus x?
Times.
Where did the 7 go?
Times by x.
So if I multiply 7 by x, all this stuff is x?
That's
it's not x minus x.
I think that's more reason.
Okay, let's talk about what this is, okay? This is 7 times x. Remember, we talked about multiplication. Beginning of class, talking about 3 times 4 is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. Okay. Well, then 7 times x must be something similar. 7 times x is really like, if I wrote it out the long way, what would that look like?
X times
x?
x plus 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 x.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plus x. That's 7x. 7 x's. If I put 7 apple there, it would be just like 7 times an apple would be just 7 apples, right? We have 7 x's. So what am I going to have when I take an x away?
6 x's.
6 x's, so 6 x.
Oh.
Okay, I'm still really confused.
Yep. You have to be able to vocalize your confusion. What is it that's confusing you?
Why would you take away an x? Oh, because of
that.
Minus x.
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go. There you go. No longer confused.
Not me. Okay.
So we have 7 x's. We have 1 fewer x, 6 x's left. Okay. It's almost like we're back to the days of first and second grade where you have 5 apples and you take 2 apples away, you have 3 apples left.
Like apples.
It's exactly what this is.
Quiet.
Isn't Olivia always the person who has the friend who had their candy stolen or had apples one time?
Friends.
Hey.
Give it now. Let's look at like one of them that has both. Like this one. 9 plus 5x minus 9x.
So 9 plus 4x.
Hold on.
Wait.
Oh. Okay. So remember why this was 6x? Because you had 7 x's and you took an x away. So you line up with 6x. Now let me ask you this. Should I do 9 plus 5x is 14x?
Yes. Minus
9. Maybe no. Yeah. I don't know. Or subtract.
Wait. Let's do wait.
Yeah, subtract
it. Yeah, subtract it. Wait.
Hold on. Why was it the 7x minus x is 6x?
Because it took away an x.
Took it away an x from what?
From the x.
From a bunch of other x's, right? I had a bunch of stuff, and I took one of those things away, right? Because they're the same. Let's talk about these things. This is 5 of what?
X.
5 of x. X plus x plus x plus x plus x. 5x. I'm not talking about this right now. I'm just talking about this 5x and this 9 situation. Is this 9 x's?
No.
No. Is it 9 of something?
9.
You subtract because it's negative 8.
Like, subtract. It would be 14x.
No, don't worry about what x is equal to. It's not equal to anything. It's just a blank spot for a number to come in later, but not yet. Let's keep it together. You're just kind of messing yourself. You're shooting yourselves in your own foot. I'm trying to help you understand this. The more I have to correct you, the less time I have to explain why these things work, and the more confused you'll be later on. The less time you'll have to do the thing the next day, and the next day, and the next day. Okay? So let's keep on track here. 5x's means 5x's added together. Okay? Is this 9x's?
No.
Right here.
No, just
9x's.
No, because there's no x by it.
There's no x. It's not saying 9 times x. It's just saying the number 9. It is 9 of something. You know what it's 9 of?
Chocolate.
Something.
Kobe.
9 of Kobe.
Something.
We don't know what x is, but this, the only thing that this is 9 of is the number 1. This is 9 number 1's added together.
Oh.
Right? That's all it is. It's like just the abstract 1, the number 1. Okay? This is 5 of something. It's 5 of x's. This is 9 of something, too. It's 9 of the number 1. Okay? So there's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So there's the 9 ones, and here's 5 x's. If I add these together, will I have 14 x's?
Yes,
it
would be 14
x's. Are these x's?
No.
No,
are these
are
x's?
Ones.
Those are
yes.
X's.
Are these ones?
Yes.
Are these ones?
No.
No.
So if I add them together, do I get will I have 14 x's?
No.
No, not like over here where I took an x away from some x's and wound up with 6 x's. Here I have 9 ones. I know, but you guys wasted my time, so we're going to stay here for a minute. And we have 5 x's, right? We do not have 14 of anything.
4 x's.
We have 9 ones and 5 x's, and that's what we have.
What'd you say?
Now, when it comes to the minus 9 x, it gets a little tricky, but these are x's. If I take, let's say I take 9 x's away. I'll take this one away. Let's get a pen here. I'll take this one away, and this one, and this one, and this one, and this way. This so far I've taken away how many?
5.
5,
but I'm supposed to take away 9.
Yeah.
I cross over into the negative x's.
4.
Negative 4x.
So
9 minus 4x.
Yeah.
Okay? Have a good day. Bye.
Yeah.